and even causing sexual health problems like erectile dysfunction. A poor chick clearly knew what's going to happen next. That's why humanity sucks. Carbon monoxide is the same chemical compound being used in the mortuaries to keep dead bodies fresh for months. And it's the same chemical compound used to preserve meat fresh for days and even weeks.
2000 years ago, Mahavir said, if you eat the flesh of an animal, the qualities of this animal will enter you. People laughed. What nonsense. If I eat chicken, will I become a chicken? I ate many, nothing happened to me. That's the argument. Today, food scientists are telling you this. When you slaughter an animal, however cunningly you do it, or however scientifically you do it, the last few moments before it is slaughtered, it will realize it is going to be slaughtered. Once it realizes, it will go through an enormous amount of tension. Suppose you realize, today 7 o'clock, we are going to slaughter you. What will happen within you? Tremendous tension, isn't it? The acidity in the body will raise when there is mental tension. So when you consume this flesh, you are consuming these acids unconsciously, and now scientists are saying you will go through unexplained situations of tension and stress within you. To give sufficient work for the doctors in hospitals.
Just have a look at another interesting fact. Herbivores like us humans have the total gut length of about 12 feet, while carnivores like tigers, being bigger than humans, have only 8 feet of gut length. But why I am telling you this? Because countries having highest meat consumption also has the largest. As per the data provided by the United Nations Food and Agriculture Organization, America and Australia are the top meat consumers, as on an average 120 kg meat is consumed by every individual in a year. Again, just have a look at data of cancer patients out of total population worldwide. 7% of American population and 4% of Australian population are cancer patients. While in India, only 1% are cancer patients out of 150 billion people, because India has the largest vegetarian population. This proves countries having highest meat consumption also have more cancer patients.
You're eating pig, guys. I can just tell you this. You're making a big mistake. Remember, the pig is the dirtiest animal in the world. It'll eat anything and anything. Remember, a cow only eats grass. Doesn't eat corn or anything or wheat or soy, but it's a vegetarian. You eat animals, okay, that are scrappers, then you get all the parasites that live in the pig. Remember, the pig, tapeworm, is bad arse tapeworm. If you've had pig, and maybe not, it doesn't matter. If you've got an egg and they secrete out 200,000 to 300,000 eggs a day, and the pig tapeworm has to go through 5 different cycles in your body. It starts in your stomach, it goes and bores out into the small intestine, to the liver, it goes to the liver, makes a house of babies, and then it goes back into the bloodstream, it goes to your brain, okay? You got lesions in your brain, you got certain things on x-rays, these are the tapeworms. They control different parts of your body by having children that this thing, this alien, goes in different parts of your body. Goes in the liver, makes babies, goes back in the bloodstream, goes into the brain maybe for next, and makes babies. Then once it's made babies in there, remember, it's making a colony, it's like a bee. It goes into your heart, makes babies, goes into your gonads, makes babies. Wow, this thing's a machine.
Around 1500 years ago in India, an ancient yogi named Maharshi Vagbhat, who lived 135 years, dedicated more than 100 years of his life researching medical science and human diet, has left behind more than 7000 guidelines for a long and healthy life. My next video will be dedicated to Maharshi Vagbhat, so don't forget to subscribe. One of the most important contributions of Maharshi Vagbhat was his division of human body into 3 parts: Vata, Pitta, and cough. According to his studies, the pith region can cause over 14 different diseases if disrupted. Even modern medical science also supports his findings, emphasizing that abdomen, the warmest part of our body, needs to be cooled down. Vagbhat's intense research revealed that consuming non-vegetarian foods are hard to digest, can increase the body temperature due to their complex chemical structure. And that's why the famous Hollywood actor Arnold Schwarzenegger says,
selling that idea that real men eat meat.
Less meat, less heat, more life.
There is something they knew, but you don't. Have you ever wondered why famous celebrities like Arnold Schwarzenegger have turned vegan? The answer lies in the gut. To make my points convincing, just have a look at this shocking clip. In the first clip, a mother in India dips her child into the holy river, hoping to cure his blood cancer. Tragically, the child doesn't survive. It's heartbreaking to see the human sufferings from cancer. Next, we see various meat sources infested with parasites, some even housing live parasites wriggling inside. Finally, a chick in poultry farm gets injected with a disinfectant containing cancer-causing compounds. But why are we showing you this? Simply to raise awareness about the health risk posed by the meat industry, which has become a major contributor to rising cancer cases and high blood cholesterol levels. Around the world, poultry farms inject animals with harmful chemicals to prevent infection outbreaks. Government regulations mandate that infected animals must be examined and often culled to stop the spread of disease, leading to significant financial losses for farmers. To avoid this, animals are injected and fed with disinfectant-laden food, which carries carcinogenic agents and even causes antibiotic resistance in your body, which will make your body to have no response when consuming medicines, and ultimately creating a serious life threat. If you are brainwashed that meat gives more power, then you need to listen to these professional athletes.
I wasn't sure if I was going to survive, and I actually became like a machine.
Hello and welcome. After watching this video, I bet you won't be able to consume meat again if you want to live a healthy life. Today we are going to dive deep into the health risk of eating meat and eggs. And by the end of this video, you will be convinced why human body is naturally not prepared for meat consumption and digestion. Let's start with an interesting observation. Have you ever noticed the similarities between animals? Those with ears popping out give birth to babies, while those without external ears lay eggs. In the same way, we can distinct differences between carnivorous and herbivorous animals. Carnivorous animals like lions and tigers drink water by lapping it up, have sharp teeth and claws, and are naturally evolved to consume meat. On the other hand, herbivorous animals, including humans, have flat teeth, longer digestive tracts, and drink water by sipping. These physical traits suggest that humans are naturally inclined towards a plant-based diet. But before we dive deeper into the science, let's talk about the meat industry. According to Statistica.com, the meat market valuation is expected to reach up to $1.7 trillion by the year 2027. With this skyrocketing demand, poultry farming practices have become increasingly questionable. Despite bans on the use of steroids and other growth hormones, animals in poultry farms are still being injected with these substances. These artificial hormones and chemicals can alter hormone levels in animals, leading to serious health concerns for humans who consume their meat. Take broiler chickens for example. These birds are bred for their muscular bodies and increased body mass. They are often kept in unsanitary conditions and injected with antibiotics and growth hormones. When consumed, these chemicals can lead to breast and prostate cancer in humans. A normal rooster takes about 25 days to mature, while a broiler chicken injected with growth hormones matures in just 10 to 15 days. If you are eating meat, you are most likely to consume these chemical residues along with it. Now let's get to scientific explanation of why meat is not meant for humans. Carnivorous animals have short digestive tract of about 8 feet long, which allow them to digest meat quickly and efficiently. Herbivores like humans have much longer digestive tract of around 12 feet. Our longer digestive process means that meat stays in our system longer, leading to potential health issues. While digestion is not the only problem here, recent studies indicate that poultry farm meats and eggs can cause cancer. Hens and roosters in these farms are continuously injected with hormones like progesterone, testosterone, and oestrogen. Red meat particularly contains high level of saturated fat, which can lead to cardiovascular diseases like arteriosclerosis. This condition decreases blood flow, increasing the risk of heart disease and even causing sexual health problems like erectile dysfunction. These health risks aren't new knowledge. Ancient Indian yogis categorized the food into two types, sattvic and tamasic. Sattvic foods are natural, moral, and easy to digest, obtained without cruelty. Whereas tamasic foods, on the other hand, are hot, spicy, hard to digest, and often obtained through cruelty. They negatively affect both body and mind. So the choice is clear. To lead a healthy life free from risks associated with the meat consumption, embracing a plant-based diet is a way to go. Thanks for watching. If you found this video informative, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Our next video will be on Maharshi Vaghmat's secret for living more than 100 years. So stay tuned.